Study is locate Genesis chapter 42 and remain seated. Genesis chapter 42 is where we're going to be in our text, but if you'll just remain seated, two announcements that I need to make real quick. One, which I oversaw or forgot to announce during the pastoral announcements, that is December the 3rd. It's coming Saturday. Or is it next Saturday? This coming Saturday, December the 3rd at 11 a.m. we will be tracing the birth of Christ. So for the you that are available and desire to share God's truth with others, not only come but bring somebody. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Tracing the birth of Christ. Amen.
Amen.
We don't have to walk around saying, well, don't nobody know when you were born. The devil is a liar.
Amen.
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 And you can know it in truth.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
Because how many of you know it's folk out there reading books? Reading stuff that you don't read. And they're learning more about your Christ than you know. Now, they're not going to serve him.
Right.
But they're learning things.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
And when you don't know about your own Christ,
that's right,
it hinders your witness.
Right.
Amen.
Yep.
Amen. So you can know the truth and you can stand in truth. Amen. Because knowing that he was born and knowing that he died and rose, our faith hinges on those truths. And you don't want somebody knocking on your door. to want to sit down on a Saturday morning with you to tell you about the birth of your Christ or the resurrection of your Christ. Amen. And you ain't got to hide from them when you know the truth.
That's right.
You ain't got to pull the drapes and be still in your own house because they knocking on your door. You ain't got to do that. That's your house.
That's right.
They'll be trying to get out of there faster than they got in there if you know the truth. Amen. 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 December the 3rd at 11 a.m. Tracing the birth of Christ. You want to bring somebody. Some of you already know I got it. We last year I got the notes. And praise God. Bring somebody. Bring somebody. People need to know God's truth.
Amen.
The other announcement is Sister Kathy DeHaven Kirk has an announcement to make.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I've had some changes going on in my life. I feel like I've always been a minister. It's just another word for servant. Years ago, I created and formed a nonprofit and worked mostly food pantry with the elderly and helped meet the needs of families with kids with disabilities. Was kind of the main thing that I did, more serving than preaching or. But God has some different plans for me.
Amen.
And this is from Isaiah, but actually I'm reading it from Luke. I love Isaiah, but I like the way it's worded. Jesus said this, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He hath sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord." Now, you know, I'm going to be truthful with you. I don't know a whole lot about deliverance, but when God speaks, when he says, it is. I do know a lot about the dung gate. And years ago, well, you know, I've had children and grandchildren and lots of foster children and other children, so I know a lot about poo. And I used to have a couple horses that I took care of by myself, and it seemed like all I did was muck the stalls. Cleaning out that poo, and I'm like, Lord, there's got to be a message in here somewhere. And he was kind of snickering because he put me in the dung gate. So I got a lot of practice in that part. So bear with me, pray for me, and we'll get through this journey together.
In case you missed it, she was trying to tell you she was called a preach. In case you missed it. Amen. Amen. And so we're going to get with Kathy and get her date for her first public sermon. Amen. It won't actually be her first public sermon. As Prophet and I know, she has been preaching for a while.
Amen.
Amen. But reestablishing your footing.
Amen.
Coming out the gate again.
Amen.
And keep her lifted up in much prayer.
Yes.
Yes. Amen.
Amen.
Because the enemy wants to stop all those whose feet come with the good news. names of Jesus Christ. Amen. He didn't want to. But the devil is a liar.
Yes, he is.
Amen.
Yes, he is.
Amen. Okay, now you can stand. Genesis. Chapter 42. Genesis. Chapter number 42. I'm going to read 8 verses out of that chapter. 8 verses. And then we're going to jump over to chapter 44 and read 2 verses. Then we're going to jump over to chapter 45 and I'm going to read 1 verse. Genesis chapter 42, beginning at verse number 1. Now when Jacob saw that there was corn in Egypt, Jacob said to his sons, "Why do you look one upon another?" And he said, "Behold, I have heard that there is corn in Egypt. Get you down thither and buy for us from thence, that we may live and not die."
Yeah.
Joseph's 10 brethren went down to buy corn in Egypt. Mm-hmm. But Benjamin.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Joseph's brother, Jacob, sent not with his brethren, for he said, "Lest peradventure mischief shall befall him." And the sons of Israel came to buy corn among those that came, for the famine was in the land of Canaan.
Mm-hmm.
And Joseph was the governor over the land, and he it was that sold to all the people of the land. And Joseph's brethren came and bowed themselves down before him with their faces to the earth.
Uh-huh.
And Joseph saw his brethren, and he knew them, but made himself strange unto them, and spake roughly unto them. And he said unto them, "Whence come ye?" And they said, "From the land of Canaan to buy food." And Joseph knew his brethren, but they knew him not.
Wow.
Chapter 44. Verse number 16. Through 18. And Judah said, "What shall we say, my lord? What shall we speak? Or how shall we clear ourselves? God has found out the iniquity of thy servant. Behold, we are thy Lord's servants, both we and he also with whom the cup is found." And he said, "God forbid that I should do so. But the man in whose hand the cup is found, he shall be my servant."
Wow.
"And as for you, get you up in peace unto your father." Then Judah came near unto him and said, "Oh, my Lord, let thy servant, I pray thee, speak a word in my Lord's ear. And let not thine anger burn against thy servant, for thou art even as Pharaoh." Chapter 45, verse number 1. Then Joseph could not refrain himself from before all them that stood by him. And he cried, "Cause every man to go out from me." And there stood no man with him while Joseph made himself known unto his brethren. For the next few minutes, I want to talk about the power of perpetual praise. The power of perpetual praise. Is that all right, brother?
Yes.
Of perpetual praise. In our text, we see Jacob and his sons faced with a crisis. They were at a stage in life where the place in which they dwelled had become lacking and inadequate. We get to those places, y'all.
Yes.
For there was a famine in the land.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Now God promised in Psalm 37 and 19 that in the times of famine, his people would be satisfied.
Yes.
You ought to write it down and highlight it because yeah. it even in these times,
yeah.
how many know it's a famine in the land?
Yeah.
And God left on record that in the times of famine,
yeah.
his people
yeah.
will be satisfied.
That's what he said.
So we don't get in a ruckus like everybody else. We don't jump around in the,
that's what he
amen.
Said.
Like frogs in hot water. Because of what's going on
right.
in society. Not if you his people.
That's right.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
He promised.
That's right.
You read it earlier in Habakkuk. He said, even though it won't be nothing in the stalls and all this stuff will be dried up around, yet will I praise him.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yet will I glorify him.
Because
he's going to make my feet like hinds' feet.
Yes.
Amen. I'm going to stand up on my high place. That's what's going to happen with me. Regardless of what's going on in the world.
Yeah.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
The psalmist says in Psalm 33 and 18, behold, the eye of the Lord is upon them that fear him, upon them that hope in his mercy, to deliver their soul from death and to keep them alive in famine. Amen. God's eyes is upon you to deliver your soul from death and keep you alive. Glory to God. Ain't you glad God's going to keep you alive? During the time of famine. The Hebrew writer said he will never leave us.
Thank you, Lord.
Nor forsake us.
That's what he said.
Matthew 28 and 20, Jesus told his disciples, lo, I will be with you.
Always.
Amen. I ain't going to mess with you, lo, Pastor Bola, but I'm going to be with you. Always.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Now, understand, don't you just run off with that if you're not his disciple.
Right.
Amen. That's not a blanket statement. That's not a general statement. He gathered his disciples together and gave them the great commission and said, and I'll be with you always. If you ain't on the great commission, that promise don't belong to you. His omnipresence is everywhere all the time, but there's a saking, an issuance of himself that goes with those of us that are on the commission.
Amen.
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 To keep us alive during famine.
Uh-huh.
Now, famine speaks of shortage,
yes.
scarcity,
mm-hmm.
and starvation as it relates to natural food and natural sustenance. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Thank you. I got my wordsmith with me. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
Sustenance. Things to sustain you.
Amen.
Food and whatever you need, material.
Amen.
Famine.
Amen.
And not only is there a famine naturally in the land, but there is a spiritual famine in the land today.
Amen.
I know I'm right about
yes,
it. There's a shortage of truth being preached.
Yeah.
A scarcity of true holiness being lived. And folk are starving for the living word of God.
Yes.
I said it's a famine in the land. And Jacob had a real simple solution to his sons. He said, why y'all standing around looking at each other? Why stand you looking one upon another? Ain't nothing here. And you can stare at each other long as you. There ain't nothing gonna be produced from staring at somebody that ain't got nothing. I'm preaching.
Well, that's the truth.
He said, why y'all looking up at each other? I understand that it's corn in Egypt. Get. Jacob said, get to where the supply is.
Yeah.
Amen. Yes. I said it's a scarcity of truth being preached.
Yes.
Scarcity of holiness being lived. Folk are starving for the living word. And I say, just like Jacob, you need to get where the supply is.
Yes.
Amen. No sister sitting up in places, drying up. Ain't no sister running amok. Amen. Jumping from place to popping around. Get where the supply is. You got to be willing to go where the supply is. Amen. And some may be listening through social media. Rolled up over out of bedside Baptist. Wondering why things are happening the way they are and why you don't have no spiritual resource and fortitude to handle. Well, you need to get to where the supply is. Book says, forsake not the assembling of yourselves together, which is the manner of some. Hebrew writer chose to point out that some folk act like that. Shulamite woman in the third chapter of the Songs of Solomon, bless her heart, took the time to take an honest inventory of the absence of her beloved.
Right.
She said, I searched for him upon my bed and found him not. Amen. In my private areas.
Yes,
and sometimes we got to take an honest inventory of his absence, y'all.
Yes,
if you don't pray at home, come on, sir.
Amen.
You know, sister, you coming up in here trying to look like you, because it's going to be abundantly clear of his absence. She took an honest inventory of her private space. I searched for him upon my bed and I found him not. When you ain't walking around your kitchen and finding the Lord, when you go in your quiet space and not finding the Lord, when you don't have time for devotions throughout your week, you need to pause long enough to take an honest inventory of his absence in your life. And she said, well, I ain't gonna stay here at bedside Baptist. She said, I'm gonna get up and I'm gonna go into the city streets and look for my beloved.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
The Bible says she went all into the marketplaces and whatnot looking for her beloved.
Yeah.
And she wasn't in the right places, but I gotta give her props for making the attempt to go looking
for her
beloved.
Yeah.
And she said, I checked out all the marketplaces and I found him not. Lord help one. Folk are going out places and not finding the Lord. Because we're not offering Christ. Offering everything but Christ. A whole bunch of presents with the T. But not his presence with the C. And they finding him not. But she went on to say, but the watchman found me. Some praying folk found me. Some praying folk found me. And she said, it wasn't long that I left the watchman that I found him whom my soul loved. Amen. You got to get to where the supply is, kingdom. Now you got to get around some praying folk. When you need to be strengthened, when you need to hear a word, when you need to get in his presence, you need to get around some praying folk. And if you're around some show enough praying folk, it won't be long when you'll find him whom your soul loves. Not who your head loves and your body loves, who your soul loves. She found him. She got to where the supply is. The supply today is the praying church amongst a praying people. Amen. Not the complaints, but the prayers.
Amen.
Everybody that show up on Sunday ain't necessarily looking to do better.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Everybody don't want to change.
Amen.
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 That's why a lot ain't gonna be here December the 3rd. Ain't because they got something to do. Hey, you ain't got nothing to do, nothing important. It's one thing to not know. But you a whole nother animal when you don't want to know.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Because there's a time I didn't know. There's a time many here that know didn't know. But the reason they're growing and the reason they're soaring is because even though there was a time they didn't know, there was never a time they didn't want to know. You ought to want to know God's truth. You ought to be willing to get up off your do nothing and get to where the supply is. Jesus said to those that would be his church, I give you the keys. I give you the keys. We got to get to where the supply is. Following God don't mean that everything is going to always be easy. But we got to follow the Father. Amen. Jacob told his sons, get to where the supply is. And it wasn't going to be easy. It wasn't going to be easy, but if they followed the Father's voice, they were going to get what they needed. The promise is not that it will be easy from the Lord. The promise is that I will be with you. Amen. Glory to God. Because I'd rather be with him in a storm than without him on the shore. It wasn't going to be easy. Go to Egypt. Get to where the supply is. Now, in Egypt, there was corn. But there was also conspiracy. They were going to find supply, but there was going to be struggle. There was fulfillment. But right there, along fulfillment was frustration. But regardless of what you run into, you better get to where the supply is. Amen. I've said it before. People complain about coming to the house of God. Saying, well, I don't go to church, but they're all a little hypocrite.
Yeah.
That's what they said.
What's wrong for one more? Amen. What's wrong? And you don't want the perfect place anyway. Amen. Because you don't want to be guilty of messing up that. Come on, somebody. But the ark was the only place of safety that God provided. When he started to rain, the ark was the only place of safety. And it was snakes on the ark. It was stinking animals on the ark. It was jackasses on the ark. But you better been on that ark when the rain came. Amen. And you can complain about whatever you run into on the ark today. But you better be there when the Lord returns. Worry about the snakes and jackasses on the ark. Get on the ark. 'Tis the old ship of Zion. Get on board. It has landed many of vows. You better get on board. That was corn and conspiracy in Egypt. But today I come to talk to you about the power of perpetual praise. We got to learn how to praise God regardless of what's going on. You see, it was a conspiracy against the sons of Jacob waiting on them in Egypt. And that conspiracy was set by their brother Joseph. Now, we love Joseph. Amen. We love Joseph. Joseph is a type of Christ. Saving people. Saving much people alive. But Joseph, I said he's a type of Christ. He was not the Christ. He was a type. Like Moses was a type. A type. Because Joseph wanted to get some vengeance for what his brothers did. Joseph didn't say, Father, forgive them. They don't know what they did. No. Joseph wanted to get some revenge on his brother. And he set up a conspiracy. And I want you to understand that you have to not allow anything to shut down your praise, because there's right, conspiracies right. Yeah. Yeah. Against the plan of God for your life. Right. There's ambushments that has been set on the path against the plan of God for your life. And your praise is going to push you through. Amen. Way back in Genesis chapter number 3. God was speaking to the serpent. And you know what happened. Man had fallen in disobedience. And God said to the serpent in the 14th verse, because thou hast done this, thou art cursed above all cattle and above every beast of the field, above and upon thy belly shalt thou go, and dust shalt thou eat all the days of thy life. And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed, and it shall bruise your heel, and thou shalt bruise his head. I will put enmity, that's hostile opposition, between your seed and the seed of a woman.
Yeah. Wow.
That's the God part of us, y'all. The seed of a woman. Now I know some of you said a woman don't have seed. What are you talking about? The seed of a woman. The seed is in the man. Am I
preaching? Yeah, you preach right there.
But Isaiah kind of cleared things up for us in the 9th chapter of Isaiah, verse number 6. He says, unto us a child is born.
Yeah.
Unto us a son is given.
Yeah.
You see, the child was born.
Yeah.
But the Son of God was given.
Wow.
The Son was given without any input from man.
Right.
Without any blood from man, the Son, there's a part of you, God Almighty, there's a part of you that ain't nobody had nothing to do with.
Right.
Not your mama, not your dad. Come on, son. Look, there's a part of you that was given. John said it like this, John chapter number 1. Go to John chapter number 1 real quick. John chapter number 1. Yeah. There's a part of you that ain't no human, nothing, nobody got anything to do with. John chapter number 1. Beginning at verse number 12, the Bible says, but as many as received him. Turn to your neighbor and say, you talking about me? To them gave he power to become the sons of God. The sons of God.
Yeah.
Even to them that believed on his name.
Yeah.
which were born. Anybody been born again?
Yeah.
Amen. Which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. Glory to God. That's the fuck. I know folk walking around them. There was a mistake, and there was somebody I didn't want, and all that. There are folk walking around right now that are born not of blood. Well, it has nothing to do with heritage or bloodline. Not of the will of flesh. Ain't because two people's flesh flared up and they got in the mood. Amen. Not of the will of man. That means it wasn't two people that decided I'd like a child and planned and went to the doctor and scheduled it. The book said not of blood, not of the will of flesh, not of the will of man, but of God. Amen. We said it before. You one in a million.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. How about that?
Science let you know it was a million sperm trying to penetrate an egg. And you the one. And they would tell him, you the one. Now don't look at them sideways, because I know it's hard to believe they made it. But I know how to believe. Don't look at them like that. You saved now. You saved now. And when I was preparing the message, the Holy Ghost said, "Write this down." But I done preached this before several times, and then I would said it in other occasions. You one in a million.
Yeah, sounds good.
In my spirit, I don't need to write it down. I know this. But he kept on insisting that I write it down. Uh-huh. And I thought it was due to, you know.
Okay.
AARP age. Maybe the Holy Ghost is letting me know. I'm your helper. I'm your helper. Write it down.
Thank you. Thank you.
And so I went to write it down, Pastor Bolaw, but when I'm going to write something down, I'm going to just relook at it just to be. That's how I do. And when I relooked at it, bless God, I saw something that I never understood before. Amen. Because in my mindset, and I always had the picture of one in a million, and all this fighting, one just make it all. Hallelujah.
Right.
I took a lot of credit for that. I'm a fighter.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
I done did it.
Yeah,
I was a fighter from the beginning.
Yeah, right.
Amen.
Hey,
one in a million. Me. One in a million, me.
Yeah.
Amen. Well, that's true that the one made it, but I always thought it was because of their own fighting them. But as I looked again, I discovered that the egg emits a chemical called chemoattractants. That's what the science called.
Chemoattractants.
Okay. The egg actually pick a sperm and emit a scent.
Come on now.
Wow.
You was chosen. Look, it emits a scent to a particular sperm that will catch the scent and find the price. You was chosen. It wasn't just about the fight, and you can't. went and got you. God ordered your steps from the beginning. God lit your path from the beginning. Glory to God. All that ought to do something in you to know that, yeah, I've grown. Amen. Since I've been with that preacher, and I've learned some things since I got saved. But the truth of the matter is, God, I was following God from the beginning. That was you was particularly chosen. The scent was sent out to you. You caught that scent. And while everything else was fighting and bumping and snatching and pulling and grabbing and bumping, you was just following the path. All that time, you had a lamp unto your footstep and a light unto your path. God was ordering your steps. Amen. Before you got here. It was a million of them.
Yeah.
And the egg said, you the one that I want. Jesus said, I chose you.
Yeah.
You didn't choose me. I chose you.
Yeah.
You the one that I want.
Yeah.
God called you from the womb.
Yes.
You ain't got a jockey for position like all the rest. Your steps will be ordered to life.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
While everybody else is bumping around and pushing and pulling and yanking and snatching and shoving and bumping, there will be a scent sent from heaven to you.
Yeah. Yeah.
That will be a lamp unto your feet and a light unto your pathway.
Yeah.
That will lead you to life.
Yeah. Yeah.
The egg chose you in the midst of millions. It saw you through the crowd. Laid eyes on you and said, you're the one, amen, that I want.
Yeah.
I wish I had a saint that ain't scared to say, ooh, ooh, ooh. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Because you're the one that I want. Amen. Amen. I didn't jockey for position. Amen. I ain't got a jockey for no job.
Yeah.
I ain't got a jockey for no house.
Yeah.
I ain't got a jockey for no spouse.
Come on,
Christ looked at me and said, you're the one that I want.
Yeah.
He will call you to life.
Yeah.
He said, I go to prepare a place.
Yeah.
If I'm going to prepare a place, then that place is for you.
Yeah.
And I'm going to come and get you.
Yeah.
I'm going to come and get you. I'm going to come and get you. For that place. Amen. Amen. You're the one that I want for that job. You're the one that I want for that work. You're the one that I want for that house. You're the one that I want for that spouse. Amen. Amen. It's not about what they want. It's about what he wants. Not of bloods and not of the will of man, but of the will of God. I'm here in the service of the Lord by the will of God. You might not like it, but I'm the one that he wants. Amen. Amen. And when you know you're the one that he wants, you can congratulate others. Amen. Because what God has for you, it is for you. Jobs you don't qualify. Amen. Keep showing up for work. Work that you was never trained to do. Keep on doing the job. People you wasn't looking for. But just keep on living for God. Because God knows how to bless his children. And you're the one that he wants. Amen. Somebody might ask you, how did you get that job? I've been working here longer. Tell them, I don't know. I don't understand, but ooh, ooh, ooh. Amen. When they train. Amen. Amen. when others got all these degrees and you ain't got the training, and they wonder why you out here training everybody and you ain't got the degree, tell them, I don't know. I wouldn't have picked me, but glory to God. Glory to God. When they looking at you wondering why they chose you, and I done got my hair and my nails. Amen. I done been to the nail shop and the shoe shop, and I call nonstop, but you the one that keep walking with them. Tell them, I don't know, but glory to God, cause you the one they want. You the one. You the one. He chose you. Ain't no explanation for you. One word. You didn't qualify. He just loved you with an everlasting love. So you ain't got to fight for nothing. Whether it's a job. Amen. Whether it's a position, a title, not whatever God has for you, you just keep on walking towards your destiny. Amen. I said keep walking towards your destiny. And if that door is my destiny, I'm going to keep on pressing toward my destiny. And it's going to be others on the path trying to get what you got. Or what God has for you. But you just got to keep on pressing past people. I said press past people and get to what God has for you. Follow the scent. And I said follow the scent. Walk in holiness and follow the scent. And he will take you from faith to faith and from glory to glory. He will direct you when others are trying to do this and trying to do that. They think this might work and they think that might work. But you keep on moving because you're following the scent. Sometimes you'll go straight. Sometimes you might have to veer to the right. Sometimes you might have to veer to the right or the left. But keep on going. I said keep on going because what God has for you. It ain't gonna make sense. Sometimes you feel like you're in a crowd of people just trying to get to the will of God. But don't get frustrated. Just keep on moving through the crowd. Amen. Ooh, ooh, ooh. I don't know what God is doing, but go from glory to glory. Faith to faith. Amen. It don't make no sense. Amen. And I ain't mad at you. Keep on. You look good. Amen. You ain't got to get jealous of folks. You ain't got to try to put out somebody else's light so you can shine. Amen. I want you to get what you believe God got for you. Because I'm going to keep on moving. Amen. I'm going to keep on moving to what God has for me. I'm not going to try to put your light out. I'm a fan. Amen. Amen. I'm not going to try to insult you. I'm going to congratulate you. Amen. I'm going to compliment you. Girl, look at the way you get them shoes at. Amen. Don't worry about her shoes. Because if it's for you, you can be barefoot. And he'll be looking at your toes. Ooh, ooh, ooh. It ain't got nothing. You got to keep on moving. I said you got to keep on moving. Don't worry about what somebody else is doing. What somebody else got, because there's a scent that you need to follow, and it's going to direct you to life. It's going to direct you to the plan of God. You follow that scent to get here. Follow that scent to glory. Well, how do I follow the sin? How do I stay on track? You got to keep praising God. You got to keep blessing his holy name. Because your praise is going to push you forward. Satan want to shut down your praise. Circumstances of life and hardships to dam up your praise. But you got to praise God. Come what will or may. Because sometimes your praise ain't even just for you. In the 16th chapter of Acts, the Bible says that Paul and Silas was thrown in the prison. And at midnight, they began praying and singing praises to God. Amen. And the Bible says that when they began praising God, all the prisoners' doors were open. And all their bands fell off. Amen. When you start praising God, you're going to set somebody else free. It ain't just about you coming out. If you praising God, somebody in that same hardship, somebody in that same prison, somebody behind that same wall, your praise, your praise, your praise is going to set the captive free. Because God is too big. When he come in a room, everything get blessed. I said, when he come in a room. Don't let nothing shut down your praise. You might be the only one in the family. Keep praising. Because your praise will be done set them free. And they'll come running like the jailer. What must I do to be saved? Amen. Glory to God. Satan knows the power of perpetual praise. And it's bad enough he can't handle you. You're a real problem when you start setting other people free with your prayer. And that's why some folk don't like you around. Because you interfere with what they're trying to do to somebody else. Hey, I said some folk don't want you around.
Don't want you around.
Because you interfere with what they're trying to do to somebody else. You don't laugh at their jokes. You don't spread their gossip. You don't avoid somebody just because they don't like them.
Glory to God.
They can't come to you with mess. You disrupt their plans for somebody else. Judah disrupted Joseph's plan to steal Benjamin away from him. Because praise exposed conspiracies. Praise exposed plots against the plan of God. You ain't got to chase rumors and chase down things. Praise will expose those things that are not God. Those plots of man. Plots of the enemy. God promised that he'll be with us. Wherever we go.
Thank you, Lord. Yeah, thank you, Lord.
Now Joseph told his brothers, I had a dream. Didn't he tell them?
Yeah.
That was a strange dream. My sheaves was standing up. And y'all had sheaves too. But they were bowing down to my sheaves. And his brother got mad. He said, what are you trying to say? You think we're going to bow down to you? And they begin conspiring one with another. We need to get rid of this dreamer. And they got rid of that dreamer.
Not for long.
But then there came a time when there was a famine in the land.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
And the Bible says that Joseph's brethren came to where he was and bowed down themselves before him with their faces to the earth. Now, Joseph told him, I had a dream. Your seeds was bowing down. Now they got rid of him, sent him on, got him sold on off into Egypt.
Yeah.
And he over there the prime minister of agriculture.
Yes, sir.
And they over there and came and starved. And Jacob said, get on over there to Egypt. Because that's where it's at.
Yes, it
is. That's where it's happening.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
You need to know that regardless of what God, what folk try to do to you, you what's happening.
Yeah.
And it's a day coming where they're going to have to come to you. Because
yes,
you what's happening.
Yes,
they're going to have to come on somebody.
Yes,
they're going to have to come to you. Because
yes,
you where it's at. And the Bible said they came to him and bowed their faces to the earth.
Yeah.
And Joseph remembered his brother. He knew who he was.
Yeah,
he did. The Bible says he made himself strange to him so they wouldn't recognize him.
Yeah.
And he talked roughly to him. What y'all want?
Yeah.
You know how you do.
Yeah.
Folk that ain't treated you right. Messed over you. They didn't hear they want to come.
Yeah.
You talking about what you want. You saw him pull up in the drive.
Yeah.
You
just wait.
You could, I can't wait to hear this.
They
trying to figure out how to get that $20 from you. They thought I would. I know I messed up. I know I ain't called. I ain't been called in the night. What you need? Joseph made himself strange to his brother.
Uh-huh.
And they didn't know him.
Yeah.
But he knew them.
Yeah.
You better be careful how you treat people.
Amen.
How you roll your eyes at them. Because while your eyes rolling, you lose sight of them. And they'll be growing and going and growing and going and growing. By the time you get fixed, they'll be in a whole nother place. Touch your neighbor, catch him. Catch him. They lost sight of Joseph. And the next time they saw him, he was in a whole nother place. But you know, child of God, sometimes you can be in a whole nother place spiritually and still got some stuff.
Because
even though Joseph was in a whole nother place, he said, I'm going to get them jokers. Y'all want? They said, well, you know, it's a famine in the land. We starving. We hungry.
Well,
our father sent us over here to get some corn.
Yeah.
But they talk too much.
Mm-hmm.
We be 12.
Mm-hmm.
And Joseph can count.
Okay.
It's 10 of y'all when I left.
That's right.
I'm 11.
Yeah.
Y'all be 12.
That's right. Okay.
All right.
New math.
And he started figuring some things.
Oh, yeah.
Rachel couldn't have no more. I mean, Leah couldn't have no more kids. And I was the baby.
Yeah.
That other would come from my mama.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no, I ain't leave my brother with them jokers.
Yeah.
Oh, no. They threw me in the ditch.
Yes.
Get my brother. I got to get my brother.
Mm-hmm.
Huh, so y'all got another brother, huh? I don't believe you're lying. Go get it.
Go get it.
They said, "Nah, we can't do that. Our father didn't want him to come. You know, so it might happen to him." You know? He said, "Yeah, I know stuff be happening to
people."
Y'all ain't getting nothing.
That's right.
Till you go get it. Y'all know the story. They went back and got Benjamin, talked the father into it. He said, "No, one of my sons missing.
Mm-hmm. No,
the other
one
be missing. And this is my baby."
That's right.
Mm-hmm. And Reuben, the oldest son.
Oh, yeah.
I promise. He's coming back. If not, I give you one of mine. I tell you, I'll fight the bear. I'll wrestle the lion. Like that. He coming back. And they get back with Benjamin. Joseph sees Benjamin. He said, "Hey. Yo, just tell the truth. All right, bless God, bless God. Let's eat. Let's eat." And while they were eating, he told his servants, "Pack their bags. Load them down with air and stuff." But in that youngest, "Put my silver cup in his bag. We're going to let him go. Then I'm going to go get him. Say somebody stole my cup. He got to stay here in my prison." And everything was going as planned. They had the feast, put the cup in Benjamin's bag.
Uh-huh.
None of the other brothers had any clue. They had a good time and going all down to the elbows. And we're going to take them all back to daddy with the daddy. It was good. It was just easy. It was time. Joseph sent them all. They just riding on going to daddy. Then all of a sudden, hooks coming behind. They got some more stuff for me? What do you want? They stop them. "We got a cup missing." Y'all get down. And they searched and found the cup in Benjamin's bag.
Yep.
And Joseph tell them, "Y'all, whoever bag I find my cup in is going to be my prisoner." They get the cup out of Benjamin's bag. Because we ain't thieves. We raggedy rascals. But we don't be stealing people's stuff. Check my bag first. When they found it in Benjamin's bag, they was in trouble. And Joseph said, "I'm keeping Benjamin with me." And nobody moved. remember Reuben. Reuben said, hey, I'm gonna make sure. But Reuben, being the eldest son, didn't say a word. Even Simeon, at this point, didn't say a word.
Wow.
Simeon names means hearing.
Okay.
Simeon represents faith.
Mm-hmm.
Faith comes by hearing.
Yeah. Okay.
But see, in a crisis, you ain't got time for faith. Mm-hmm.
Wow.
See, faith worked when they sent him home the first time.
Uh-huh.
You remember he sent him home to get Benjamin.
Right.
He said, I'm going to make sure y'all come back. One of y'all going to stay here until y'all come back.
Mm-hmm.
They made Simeon stay back.
Oh.
While they went.
Right.
Because Simeon could wait. Because
mm-hmm.
Simeon is faith.
Okay.
Faith can wait.
Yes.
And so they put faith down in the dungeon. And faith, you see, real faith don't get upset. Real faith don't get twisted. Real, you can't mess with faith.
That's right. Okay.
And they had a guard over faith.
Yeah.
Antagonize. Your brother's gone. You sure they're going to come back? You in trouble. Ain't you scared? But faith.
Faith. Yeah.
Bless God. Somebody say bless God for faith. Faith was sitting there. Trusting with all his heart.
Yeah.
I know my brother's coming
back.
Yeah. I know God is going to make a way.
Yeah.
I know it's going to be all right.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Your faith will flip the script on the enemy.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
I can imagine Simeon sitting down there saying, they keep you down here too? Stay down here, don't you? You got to be down here. Amen. Waiting on his brother. But when they came back and they got in a crisis, Simeon ain't say nothing. Because when you're in a crisis, you ain't got time to remember scripture. I mean, this thing about to happen right now when your car hit a patch of ice.
Amen.
You ain't got time to faith.
Amen.
Faith works when you got time.
Amen.
Faith works when they say in 30 days.
Yeah.
Faith works when they say in so much that you can faith and believe, but in a moment.
Yeah, right.
Glory to God. You better learn how to praise, because in a moment, stuff may not make sense. In a moment, you won't know what to think or what to say or what to believe. And in a moment, you gotta have a praise in your belly.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
I know you're right.
Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
When the wall on one side and 18 wheel on the other side, you ain't got no scripture. You just gotta hold on. You better have a pray.
Yeah.
Protocol didn't speak.
That's right.
Even though protocol promised.
Yeah.
Faith didn't speak.
Because
faith ain't got time. But Judah. Judah.
Yeah.
His name means pray.
Yeah.
And they were in a crisis.
Yeah.
And the Bible says Judah spoke up.
Yeah.
He didn't wait on Reuben. I know protocol should be talking right now. But protocol don't always move like protocol. Y'all ain't gonna help me.
Yeah.
And praise spoke up and said, listen here.
Yeah, yeah.
You caught us. We are all guilty. And that's real praise. Real praise admits that I ain't do nothing of myself.
Yeah.
I don't deserve nothing.
Yeah.
Everything good that happened to me is because of God.
Yeah.
Judah said, we are all guilty.
Hallelujah.
And Joseph said, no. I'm going to let y'all go. And I'm going to keep Benjamin.
Yes, sir.
Real praise don't start at stop at partial blessings. I said real praise don't stop at partial blessings. Fake praise will take what it can get for itself and run on. I said fake praise will take what it can get for itself. And I said fake praise. Fake praise will take what it can get for itself and run on out of here. Can't even wait for the benediction. Can't even wait for the close of the service. Got my blessing and gone. Don't care if nobody get healed. Don't care if God wants you after the service to pray for somebody. Don't care. I said fake praise will take their blessing and run on. But real praise said, I ain't going nowhere until my brother. Real praise wait on the fullness of the blessing. Real praise want everything God said. I want everything God said. I want everything God said. I want everything God said. If God said 5-bedroom, 3-car garage, then this apartment is nice, but it ain't what God said. And I'm going to keep on pushing. I want all that God said. Yes. And so praise said, let me whisper in your ear.
Okay.
Let me come closer. Yes. Amen.
Lord,
sometimes you got to look, get a little closer to the Lord in your praise.
Yes.
Sometimes you got to push a little further in your praise.
Yes.
Sometimes you got to be steadfast and unmovable. In your praise, keep on pushing, keep on pressing, keep on praising God. And the Bible says, after a while, praise, talking to Joseph, Joseph had to break down and expose the conspiracy. I'm telling you, if you keep praising God, it will expose the plans of folk against you. It'll have folk come up to you and apologize for stuff that you didn't even know they did. I know I'm right about it. It'll make folk change their mind about you. Amen. It'll make folk change direction against you if you just keep on praising God.
Amen.
It's the power of perpetual praise. I said it's the power of perpetual praise. Not your first little hallelujah, but it's the power of perpetual praise. Not your first little glory to God, because the storm will rise up against your initial praise. But you gotta keep on praising God. You gotta keep on praying. Don't give up on God. I said don't give up on God. The disciples was on the ship and the storm began to rise and water came in the boat, but they had to keep on going. The Lord don't move until your praise get right. Amen. Hey, I said the boat didn't fill up immediately. Water came in the boat. And just like some of us, the first time water hit us, the devil is a liar. Amen. But the water kept on coming. And then the Bible says they called everybody to help row, because the boat is getting filled up. And you know, the first time we say the devil is a liar.
Yes.
But when the water keep on coming, then we say all hands on deck. We call our prayer partners. We call the preacher. We call anybody that know the word of prayer. Amen. All hands on deck. And when everybody's praying and everybody's in place and the water keep on coming in the boat, that Bible says that they ran down and woke up Jesus and said, care us not that we perish. Soaking wet, mouth full of salt water. Look like God ain't moving on their behalf. But if you keep on pressing, I said, keep on pressing, keep on pressing, and the Lord will stand up in your behalf and calm the storm. It's the power,
power
of perpetual praise.
Yeah.
That's why Satan hates you.
Uh-huh.
It's because of your praise, y'all.
Yeah.
It's because of your praise.
Uh-huh.
And you got to continue to praise God.
Yeah.
Regardless of what's going on.
That's right. All right.
And he's going to fight your praise.
Yeah.
And not only must you praise him, you got to be praising to the point that you become a praise.
Oh, wow.
I'm coming all around the corner, y'all.
To
the point you become a praise.
Yeah.
Peter says you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood.
Yeah.
That should show forth the praises of him that brought you out of darkness into his marvelous light. To the point that you be a praise unto the Lord.
Yes.
Praise means to brag. You got to brag on God to the place where he start bragging on you. I said you got to brag on God to the point that he start bragging on you.
Thank you, Lord.
At the point that when he started looking at you, at the point that when you dance and you brag, you make God dance.
Yeah.
Come on, touch the name and say, make God dance.
Yeah.
Make God dance.
Yeah.
Brag on him.
Yeah.
Praise his name.
Yeah.
Glorify him.
Yeah. Yeah.
Make him look at you
yeah.
and say, that's mine right there.
Yeah.
You see, Satan going to hell, y'all. Oh, he going to hell. But it ain't because of look, acts of sin. Satan ain't never stole nobody's car. You never robbed no bank. He ain't never cheated on his spouse, smoked a joint. Say they ain't nothing doing that. But what you do?
That's right.
That's right. What I did.
Come on.
Acts of sin. Say they never did none of that.
That's right.
He influenced.
Yeah.
See, the reason Satan going to hell, because he decided one day he wasn't going to show up for work. Satan was set and designed to usher the praise.
That
was his job. I said that was his job. He was the anointed cherub that covered. He was beautiful. And his pipes was formed in him.
Yeah.
He didn't just offer praise. He was the praise. And it was his job to usher in glorious, beautiful praise. And Satan decided one day he wasn't going to show up for work. And sometimes, it could be, the Lord ain't moving on your behalf. Because you keep not showing up for work. Because when he removed Satan, he said, let us make man in our image and after our likeness. And he set you to praise him. And he set you to be a praise in the earth. And you better show up for work. I don't care what's going on in your life. I don't care what's happening in your life. Don't you call off on praise. I said, don't you call off on praise. Get dressed and go to work. Put on your garments of praise. Don't call in sick. Bring the sickness with your praise. And if you show up for work, the Lord will. The Lord will. The Lord will. heal your mind. He'll heal your body. But you got to show up.
Show up.
You got to show up. You got to show up for work. You got to show up for work, y'all. I said you got to show up for work. You got to let that praise be in you continually. Don't you stop praising him. I'm on down the hill now, y'all. You better get ready to let it go. You, don't you stop praising him. Don't you let nothing dam up the praise that was supposed to flow out of you. Don't you get so mad that you can't praise. Don't you be so hurt that you can't praise him. Don't you be so confused and messed up that you can't praise him. In the midst of it all. In the midst of it all. Bless the Lord. Oh my soul. And all. And all. And all. Come on, stand to your feet. And all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Don't you get mixed up and tripped up with who you set to be. Satan got off his job. And he got kicked out. One of his names is Haleo. We know Lucifer, son of the morning. And he done became the devil and accuser of the brother. He had all our names. And one of them is Haleo, which means to celebrate. He was supposed to start the celebrations. But he changed the name from Haleo to Haleo. Where we get the word celebrity. Because he wanted to praise for himself. So instead of celebrating, he wanted to be the celebrity. He wanted to be the one that was celebrated. So instead of the praise coming through him, he wanted the praise to come to him. Don't you get confused about who you are in his presence. Don't get caught up in the praise outside of you. Be a praise. Bless the Lord. Praise will confuse the enemy. Praise will destroy everything he had set up for you. Praise will reverse the curse. Praise will reverse the curse. I said praise will reverse the curse. No wonder the 146 psalms start out with praise ye the Lord. Amen. And it ends up with praise ye the Lord. The psalmist was adamant about us praising God. The 147th psalm, amen. It starts out praise ye the Lord. And it ends up with praise ye the Lord. Have you read the 148th psalm? It starts out praise ye the Lord. And it ends up with praise ye the 149th psalm. Starts out praise ye the Lord. And it closes out with praise the 150th psalm. It starts out praise ye the Lord. And it closes out let every day. Let every day. Let every day that has breath praise ye the Lord. Amen. I'm glad it said that has breath. And not a Mercedes. And not a house on the hill. But if you got breath, and I don't care what condition that breath is in, if you got breath, I said, I don't care what condition, come on, brother, that breath is in. Whatever the condition, that breath is in. Praise ye the Lord. Bless his name. Glorify him. It may not be in the best state, but I got breath. And if you got breath, you ought to bless his name. If you got breath, you ought to open up the floodgates and bless his name. The prisoners are lifted. Set the captives free. I would bless the Lord at all times. In all times. Let all of heaven hear your praise. Let everything on earth works. Yeah.